Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro Partner providing Mailchimp training and consulting services. Today I'm going to cover tags. I'm going to explain what tags are in Mailchimp and then how we can work with tags. So let's go across to Mailchimp. I'm viewing my audience at the moment. Now, tags are something we add to our contacts in our audience. Think of a tag as a label. It could be brand names, it could be salespeople's names, it could be gender, it could be the country people are in. Whatever's convenient for your business, your organization, and how you want to label people. Of course, in Mailchimp, we can send an email, for example, to our entire audience, a segment of our audience, which I cover in a different instructional video, or we can even send to tags, but we can include tags and segments too. The difference between tags and segments really is that a segment is a search of our data in our audience, whereas a tag is a label we apply to certain people or contacts in our audience. And again, you can decide which labels you want or which tags you want. So I'm looking at my audience. I merely clicked audience to the left-hand side of the screen and all contacts, and I've got various people here. Now, we have the tag field over here, and whenever I add tags, they will be added into there against the relevant people. You can have as many tags as you want in Mailchimp. There's no limit. You can have as many tags against any person in Mailchimp too. The only limit is that each tag can be a maximum of 100 characters. Unlimited number of tags, but a limit of 100 characters per tag. Okay, so we can have 20 tags, 30, 40 tags against this person if we really wanted to. Adding tags is simple. Let's do this. Let's label certain people as Australia. I happen to be in Australia, so let's do that. Let's say, and I'll show you a few ways we can tag people. Let's say that person, that person, that person, that person, and that person are all in Australia. We can check their names. Click add or remove tags, and quite simply type in the tag, or the label in this case that I want to use. And again, this will be for your own purposes. So I've clicked on that, and you'll notice now that those people that I checked all have Australia in the tag. I could also do this. I could also click on any, let's go for this person. Let's just click on this person's profile. I'm just clicking on their email address. And we'll just see another way we can add a tag. You'll notice here tags and the person's tags. We could delete the tag against them. We can even add. So I'll click the plus and let's create one called Singapore, for example. And we'll say this person has a tag of Singapore. Now they've got both. Let's go back to our audience. Okay, so we'll see that that person now has Singapore and Australia. These others are still there. I'll show you yet another way we can tag people. This is called bulk tagging. So if you've got the email addresses of people already in your audience and you want to bulk tag them, this is very handy. So for example, I work with a very big company. They had a huge audience and they wanted to tag people that were already in the audience with a salesperson name that deals with those people. So quite simply, the contacts are already in the audience, and then we just bulk tag them. We import the email addresses and add a tag of the salesperson's name. So we can go to manage contacts and then tags. So I've clicked tags. If we want to bulk tag people, we can quite simply click bulk tag contacts. Add the tag. So let's say I want to tag all the people I'm about to paste as USA. I could upload a file, but I'll just paste a few email addresses for now just to demonstrate. And I can either tag these email addresses or tag everyone except those. And I'll click Save Tag. So I'm expecting that those people would then have been tagged with USA. Let me just go back to my audience. So I'll just click all contacts. I'll just scroll down and you'll see that those people now have been tagged as USA, and you'll notice that they just keep sort of going. A few ways you can manage tags. As we saw, we could go into the individual person We could then tag people or even delete a tag. I just click the little cross to delete the tag, and I'm going to go back to my audience. Another way, and you might have seen it a little bit earlier, if I click Manage Contacts, Tags, you can manage tags here. So I could view, I could click view, you know, against the tag name and view all people that are in that tag. I can click the little down arrow here, and I can even send a very quick email campaign, a regular campaign, for example, to all people that are tagged that. It's a nice quick shortcut rather, sorry. I could rename the tag. There's no danger in renaming it. It just renames it to something else. You could delete that tag. And all that does, if you delete, it won't delete the people in your audience. It'll just delete the tag against people's names or where they were tagged a certain thing. It'll just delete the tag, that's all. Or you can export as CSV the people that are in your, for example, Australia audience. Another way you might have seen how to tag people is during an import from Excel or a CSV file. During that, there's actually a step that says, do you want to tag people as you're importing them? And that's another way you can tag people. So there we go. Many ways you can manage tags, add tags. The important thing to remember is that a tag is just a label. You can make it up for your own purposes by the product name, the service, whatever. You make it up for your own needs, and it's just a way that we label people. But thanks for joining me. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.